Robert E. Lee insisted that he was prepared to sacrifice anything to preserve the Union, except honor. Honor forbade him from taking up arms against his own people, and upon that loyalty, Lee acted upon his conviction.
He was selfless almost to the extreme, and an example of that is that he turned his back on the United States military, which had been his love and his career, to defend Virginia.
One of the best examples of Robert E. Lee's character took place here at St. Paul's Church, just a few months after the end of the Civil War. What Lee did on that day stunned this congregation.
During a communion service, church members were startled as a black man came forward and knelt at the altar to receive the consecrated bread and wine.
And nobody knew what to make of it. I mean, the war had just ended. And Dr. Minigro, the rector, and others just froze. And in that moment, this figure emerged from the congregation and knelt next to the black man, and everybody relaxed, and things went on as they usually did. And,
because that figure was?
Was Robert E. Lee.
He was very clear on the demonstration he was making, that this was the way the world was going to be, and that we needed to accept each other at par, not to judge each other as black or white, former slave or defeated soldiers.
Like Thomas Jefferson, Lee did own slaves, but thought slavery was evil and worked toward reconciliation until his death in 1870.
He worked within the limitations of his society and what he knew, you know, at that time, but he was also a person who, you know, cared deeply for all human beings.
It's a matter of assessing the whole man, his whole life, his whole career, and not, I think, picking and choosing either something that pleases or displeases you.